I asked how many of the kids' parents were in band. How many parents in here were in band? Raise your hand. Yeah, quite a few. So we know that even playing simple songs are important. You know, we're learning rhythms, and we're learning what a quarter note is, and what a note is on the staff, and we're clapping. We count rhythms every day, right? We echo play, so we're playing things, we're learning fingerings on the recorder. All of these basic skills that are going to translate to when they get their instruments. So, like I said, while they may seem like simple songs, a lot was put into getting that prepared for October. And also, we did a lot of prep in knowing what these instruments are, you know, what a French horn is and what a clarinet is and things. And a lot of kids have selected their instruments. Raise your hand. Who's going to be playing French horn? Raise your hand. Who's French horn players? Okay. And who's our flute player? We got a couple flute players, that's right. And who is our clarinet players? Yeah. And who is our trumpet players? Saxophone, trombone, and percussion. Yeah, percussion. Yeah. So we watched a lot of videos. I've demonstrated a lot of things in class about the different instruments, and so they have a good, solid foundation about what they're going to get themselves into. So here's our second tune. Our second tune is going to play twice because we'll be able to repeat sign. This is going to be a Au Clair de la Lune or a song of moonlight. So hope you enjoy. So here is Country Walk. So I have Cameron in front of me, just in front of me during class, and I have a few other sixth grade students that are in Northern Michigan virtual that are learning along with us during class. So it's sort of like teaching two classes at once, and it's funny because I'll talk to the kids and the band's like, "Who are you talking to, Mr. Parent?" But now they know who's in band, and it's been fun. So we've got a few kids at home who are going to have instruments as well, and they're going to be learning from home at the same time with the band. So they show up to class in Google Meet every day with us, and they have their cameras on, they're participating, and they're getting feedback, and so that's been interesting, to say the least. So fun. The kids enjoyed it. The goal for me was if they wanted to see my learning instrument, I didn't want to deny them that, even though they were learning online because of our current situation. So I'm happy to provide that opportunity to them, and hopefully they'll pay off tomorrow. The last tune is a tune called Lucky Row, and this one's a duet. So we know that a duet is two things going at the same time that have slightly different melodies. So we have a group one, so sixth graders. Who's group one? This is our group one kids. Not to say they're better, but I just number them all. Okay. Who's group two? Alright, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to play this two times for you guys. And we're going to do this. Group one is going to play the A line. It's going to have higher notes on it. That's the A line in their book. And then group two is going to play the B line. That's going to have the lower notes. But we're going to play it together, so we're going to have some harmony. Okay? And this is Lightning Row. And then we'll play it again for you. Okay? You ready?